Okay, sorry for that. My Dota, for some weird reason, just crashed. But that doesn't matter. We're right here now with the Corsair Gaming Arena number 5. This is the 8th final, and the match is between Rip the Dream and Execration. Execration has just had a gruesome best of 3 versus Mnatsky. They were able to win it 2-1. And now they're here to see if they can get some money out of the Corsair Gaming Arena. And, well, I am Sander, I will be your caster for this match, and yeah, let's just go into it and see how everything goes. Again, I'm sorry for the bit of the delay as well, so, but it doesn't matter anymore right now, and so we're into our pick and ban phase here with first bans Tusk and Lashrak for Rip to Dream. Pretty casual bans here, it's nothing out of the ordinary, to be honest. It's just strong heroes, utility, the lane domination, it's just all there, and Execration ends back with a Bloodseeker as well as a Queen of Pain ban. Also bans that we've seen, well, before. So nothing too special in over there, and Rip to Dream, this of course does offer up the Shadow Fiend here, and they grab it straight away. They are on the dire side though, so it's not as useful as is on the Radiant due to the fact that you can't stack a camp that easily. And they're also able to get their hands on the Winter Wyvern, a hero that has been prioritized by many teams as of late. It's a strong hero, long range, slow for the beginning of the match, can keep the enemy offlane a little bit annoyed as well as being on a dire, able to go from the Ancient, go over the cliff there and just get an easy gank onto the mid laner there. And Execration, they get back an Earthshaker and Storm Spirit, so they already have both of the mid laners here. Storm Spirit is gonna be it for Execration. It fares okay-ish versus Shadow Fiend until Shadow Fiend has a bunch of raises. Then Storm will fall off a little bit. He will take too much harass and he has to wait for his level 6. So from like level 3 to 5, Storm is gonna fall off a little bit more. He might need to go and stack the medium camp and get back from that if he needs to. And they also get the Earthshaker, just pretty much an all-around support here. He can initiate once he has a Blink Dagger. In the beginning it's kind of fissures, long-range initiation, but it's not as good as this, of course, with a Blink Dagger. And also the defensive capabilities of him should be able to help out the Storm Spirit in mid once they try to rotate on top of him. Then we see the bans coming out. We see a Darkseer and a Dying Ban here from Execration. Usually when I see a Darkseer ban, the first thing that comes into my mind is that they're gonna go and pick up a Malik core for their safe lane. Usually once you have ranged heroes there, you don't care that much about a Darkseer, because you should be able to farm or just kill off the creep quite easily. And apart from that, of course, I honestly really like the heroes, it's incredibly strong. And Undying as well, it's just this lane dominator again. Already having picked up two strength heroes here, so as well, both of them are melee, and those pesky little zombies can get in your way if you hookshot quite easily as well. And the Radiant side clockwork, yeah. What to say about it? Yeah, it's not as good, of course, as it is on the dire side, where you can just go into your along of the path on the bot lane, you can just put them away in the woods for quite some time, and it will push the lane way, way back to your tower, making your life a whole lot easier. Sadly, that isn't the case with Radiant, so it's a little bit hang. Still, you can block the wave quite easily as well as just keep, maybe one creep usually gets out of there, but it's just that one creep and will eventually push back to you anyway then. And Rip the Dream, they had some time to think, and they went for the Windranger here. I'm not sure yet if it's going to be a safe lane or off lane Windranger. It might even run to support here. It's kind of this hero that you can just put anywhere. It can fulfill any role if you want to. I don't especially like it as a support. I think it needs levels way too much to get, like, you know, you need to fast level 11 if you can on a Windranger. You need to get a level 2 focus fire, and you just get so much more out of it if it's a core, and it is gonna be a core here. I think this is gonna be an offlane Windranger with a save lane Shadow Fiend and a mid Viper. Yeah, that's usually the best laning situation here. They might actually even go for an IO here for Rip the Dream. They have really strong lanes here, so just having an IO together with a Shadow Fiend somewhere might actually work out really, really well, and it will create pretty strong lanes. Since you can just poop the Viper on the safe lane as well and still dominate the lane over there versus the Clockwork. It just really opens up a lot here, and we'll see what Extra Crazy thinks about it. I know that IO isn't really the most played hero in the SEA scene, so it's kind of doubtful, but having these strong lanes really does open up an IO. Maybe even a jungler here as well. But we'll see what Rip the Dream goes for. And Excavation think they're gonna pick up another support, and they just ban out the Witch Doctor here. But Excavation, let's talk a little bit about Skyriff mage here. It's a pretty strong hero for Windwaver, and you know, you use Cold Embrace on someone, and it's kind of like a setup for your own Mystic Flare. You can just throw it on top of it and still kill him off. And also, you can just get an easy Ancient Seal Nymph as well, and just get a complete combination on him. As well as just the instant cast of the Ancient Seal is also really, really strong for his Windwaver. It can completely destroy him. Though it's not that strong for his Viper, he has extra magic resist, just being tanky as well. It's okay for Shadow Fiend until Shadow Fiend, of course, got his BKB, which is kind of inevitable. He is gonna get it somewhere along the way. And Wind Ranger, he's. Well, kind of depends on how they're gonna play him, but usually you get a BKB somewhere along the line. So we'll see for that. But apart from that, it's also just a strong laning support. Can harass out the enemy offlaner pretty, pretty well. If this is going to be the Wind Ranger here, he's not going to have a good time. He might have to pick up a stick fairly early just to get some kind of things about out of the lane. It's going to be just really, really tough for the Skyriff mage here. And as Rip the Dream, they think they're going to pick up a save link links here. Having another Orchid, that's going to be quite hard for Rip the Dream to deal with. I can see why they go for it. It's just annoying hero to deal with, as well as it's just. Just painful, and Execration do need a position 1 core, but I'm not completely sure what they're opting for right now. There's even a possibility of going Anti-Mage, so it's fairly greedy, and but they can actually do it over here. Spectre is open, Phantom Lancer as well, but they opt to go for a really mid-game lineup here. Having a setup as well between Scarf Mage and Clockwork, of course, with the Cox and Mystic Flare. Also having Juggernaut here, who's also more mid-game oriented than one of the other carries that I just said. And Rip the Dream, let's see how they're gonna answer back on this. Are they gonna pick up a jungler or another support, or do they say Wind Ranger is gonna be a support as well, and we pick up an offlaner here? For offlaners, there are not that many left though, so Centaur is still a possibility, but he also gets kind of a rest out, and they're gonna pick up another support here in the Abaddon. So that's going to be a fun thing to see here. He's probably going to be carrying a TP through the entirety of the match. Just, you know, TP into the lane if they need help. And it will make ganking a lot harder, of course, with an Abaddon. But he needs his levels. Level 1 Apothic Shield is kind of iffy. It still does what it needs to do, but it's a hero that wants his levels as well. It's a pretty level-dependent support here on R2D. Windwaven, he wants his level 6. Doesn't need it entirely in the beginning, but so it would be nice to have, and I think that Execration is a little bit more less reliant on levels here as well as on farm. So we'll just see who hits their stride first. One good thing I want to say that RTDF, they have a lot of potential mech carriers. Viper is able to carry it, of course, as well as the Shadow Fiend. So I'm just fun to see how that one goes all here. But just let's just go and start with the Winter direction of the teams here. We have on the Radiant side Execration. We have Abang playing the Juggernaut. Lumic playing the Skyriff Mage. Storm Spirit is going to be played by Nando. Fox is going to be playing the Earthshaker. And that leaves Primo on the off lane Clockwork. Indiana is going to be playing for R2D on the Dire side on the Wind Ranger. We have Winter Wyvern being played by Sita Boy. I need to practice on that one. Bende is going to be playing the Shadow Fiend. And Burden is going to be playing the Viper. And Kev is going to be playing the Abaddon. We're going in for a little bit of an aggressive movement here into the Radiant Jungle. Looking to get maybe a ward out or something. Although they don't carry any wards here. Stumboy, he is the one whose head is. Seatumboy. Seatumboy, damn it, that's it. But yeah, he hasn't been able to place one. Who is, does the other one have? Indiana? No. Did he already place one, maybe? Hmm. Some long-range artillery coming out from the Skyrim mage here. They're gonna try and secure this bounty room, but this is not securing it. This is just throwing down a fissure and Band-Aid is still able to just pick it up as easy as that. Well, Storm Spirit is able to pick up the top one. Just throwing out some remnants here to just make sure that Indiana is kind of thinking twice about it. And they're gonna go for an aggressive trialing here on R2D. No dual lane. Seaton Boy is going top. Okay. Let's see how it is fair. They have a fairly strong lane here. Pretty defensive as well with the Abaddon. Should be able to save the Viper quite easily, but it's still pretty hard to lane to be against. You're gonna get those arcane bolts thrown at you at all time, and if you're too far forward, Fissure will block you out, and it doesn't really matter if you have an apodic shield then, because you can't walk through it anyway. So you're gonna be stuck there. So far, mid Nando has been doing pretty well here versus Bandit, just pushing lane all the way back to him, just being able to pick up two so far. He went for the raises first, now builds up some oh, what? In Burden, he went aggressive. This is what I talked about. This dual lane into this defensive trial lane is just so hard to deal with. The Fissure won't save you. Well, I mean, the Apodic Shield won't save you from a Fissure. It will keep you blocked out and make sure that you can't get away from there. And that's just not something that this dual lane is able to stand against in the early game. In the early first levels. It's, they need their at least their level 5 or something along those lines for some corrosive skin levels. Miskoi as well as a high level in the Apodic Shield. And are they able to keep up Prima out of the XP range even? They're not. He even gets a couple of last hits as well. So it's not really working out here because Seaton Boy, he's just walking all the way through the map and looking for stacks here. And this means that the Clockwork is just having a good time as well. He gets some Erasmus on top of him from Indiana, but it's nothing too big. So far, when it's Excreation, is really just getting the better trace out of this. At least they're able to get some rune control here. If Kev is able to pick this one up, he is. He gets an invisibility rune, so Lumic just leaves him there. Goes back to lane, and we might see another thing going here soon. Since Urchek is on mid here, is he looking for aggressive here, or maybe for just his level 2, as it seems like? He was looking. He thought maybe Winter Wyvern is going to try and do something funky here, because he was off the map for quite some time, and he didn't. So now rotates back to bot, and we might see something going on here. They're fairly aggressive forward here on the side of RTD. Kev is invisible though, so he's able to spell out any rotations here. But yeah, at the same time, are they keeping Abing down here? It doesn't really seem like it. He is holding up on last hits on the versus the Wind Ranger here, so did miss one there. Lumic getting some harassment here. They're just waiting for them to go forward. They pull down lane and they're kind of trying to bait R2D into something that they don't want to do, and they just leave it and go back to the lane. Give the experience here to Fox. I'm gonna see. I really want to see what they're gonna do with this dual lane. They're not really getting a lot of farm. Absolutely getting no farm at all. They're getting the denies on top of them all the time, and this will hurt their economy pretty hard. Since they're not really keeping Storm down that much. As I said before, you know, this 3-2 level 5 mark for Nando on the Storm Spirit here is going to be hard for Shadow Fiend. He just got a couple of levels in his race. A little bit of Necromancy, and Nando will probably resort to some stacking here fairly soon just to get his levels up. Or get some return farm. He might as well just stay in lane as well, just up for the experience, but we'll see what he ups for. Both of them are, of course, a possibility, but one good thing here for RTD is that with this dual lane and the solo lane on top, that leaves the Winter Wyvern to just go over the map, all over the map, and just start stacking everything. Though the Ancient might be a little bit hard to take down anytime soon here. I mean, what's he going for so far? He has 22 last hits, 23 now. He's holding up close with Bandai here. Well, so that we, of course, have Indiana here on top. The Clockwork Primo is doing fine as well. 19 last hits on mid Nando. As I said before, he's struggling to keep up with the Storm Spirit against the Shadow Fiend here. They're trying to go in here. Fissure is there, but it's on the wrong side, and Bende is just fine. Eats some harassment, but he has his Bulldog, can heal up, back up, and even a Cold Embrace is there to help him out as well. And it's just always just go back to farming here. They know Abing is here alone, so they move in a little bit more aggressively. Kev walks forward, trying to harass him out, make him think twice about getting some CS. And Abing here just respects it a little bit. Yeah, he walks forward, he gets an instant poison on top of his face. So he's looking out here. He got a kill now as well. As they're looking for something here on top for execration, looking at Indiana, but. How are they gonna do this? The lane is all the way back at the tower here. And they even pull now. This might be a possibility. Oh, who shot Wiz on Steamboy Boy here? He still keeps him walking forward. He's just gonna try and steal the creeps from here. Denying farm and levels to Steamboy Boy. Oh, this could be a good shackle shot. Yes, he will, but the Cox keeps them out. Draining a lot of mana here. Steamboy Boy is quite low, but I don't think they can kill him. No, they're not. He's already close at the tower here. And they just move away from here. Maybe give Fox a little bit of level. Oh, what? Primo, yeah. Yeah, they're gonna just secure the top rune right now at the 6 minute mark. Well, Storm, he stacks up the minion camp, goes for the bot rune. And now you can see just some strong rune control coming out from Execration. Indiana. I'm really wondering what this build's gonna be. Are we gonna see like an Aghanim's build here? Or, you know, the Slasher's way or... We're gonna see something more in the lines of the old school builds, with maybe a Maelstrom first. As we I miss a kill on the Vibe here, but Primo Nando, he went for a gank there. After picking up the rune, they are able to pick up the Viper and giving some more space. Ebbing here, he picks up his face boots now as well. As Lumic, he just drags his lane all the way back. He ate a lot of harassment here. It's pretty low on HP, and he will just opt to go back to base. They gave the ward to Nando, so he might be looking for something else right now. He's gonna keep on stacking here. This is what I talk about. Just get those stacks up and have something to go back, to fall back upon. Because, you know, Shadow Fiend will take more farm out of the mid lane, and just having that is able to just bring it back a little bit more into the game. Winter Riven, he's level 3 right now, it's not getting that close or anything. Primo, he doesn't have his hook shot up. He did use it again fairly. And now we're seeing some aggression here from Execration on the mid lane. Rotating in 3 people, the ward from R2D did spot it out, so... You can see Bende just staying behind this tower on the opposite side. Making sure that Fox cannot get off a easy... Fissure here, but that does mean that the tower is gonna take a lot of harassment. It's already down to half HP. The TP in the Winter Wyvern here, but they just walk back. Oh, what? Winter Wyvern? It wasn't the Winter Wyvern, it was the Abaddon, because he was found out here. And they kill him off and kill for Fox here. I looked at the wrong colors. That's green and blue. My bad here. So a little bit early for me. I'm sorry about that. And, Etang, he needs to go back to base here. Level 5 Viper was a little bit too much for me. Ate a lot of harassments and... Bende, he's looking for him, but he's not gonna find him right now. Is he gonna find Fox here? Maybe on the retreat. There's no mana on him, but... Are they gonna go for him? Fox is walking away from him and doesn't seem like they're able to go after him. If he shows himself on the lane, that might be a bit of a mistake. Is there Viper strike up? No, just 200 more XP. Bende, he pops his haze, he's looking for him. He's gonna go after him. They're gonna go into him aggressively, and this one might have been a little bit too fast. They might get Ebbing here, but he does have his Omni Slash though. Oh, Bende, he's behind the creeps. There's gonna be the Omni Slash onto him, Burden. There's gonna be the Fissure as well. Bende is on the other side now. Ebbing, oh, he gets Shackle Shot rotation in from Indiana, and they kill him off with some simple right clicks. Where is Fox right now? He is hidden in the trees. He's gonna get out. He's just gonna be a-okay. Well, here on the mid lane, Kev is taking a lot of harassment. Is he gonna die to Nando? Yes, he is under the tier 1. Rotation in from Bende now. Is there gonna be the raise? No, the raise misses. Making sure that they can't get any more kills. He steals a soul ring as well to zip out if he needs to. Yeah, Primo's gonna go back to base and look for a gank here. He has his hook shot up. So if Bende keeps on being aggressive here, they might go for him. They will need to look out a little bit on Nando here. Oh man, these hits from 36 stacks here on Necromancy do a lot of damage. He's just harassing 2 people out of the lane. Will almost dive underneath the tier 1 tower here. Bender going aggressive a little bit, and he didn't need to get the runes here. And if Bender is able to go there, they're rotating in three people from R to D, and Nendo is just not able to contest it one way or another. He needs to go away, look for the top tier, top rune here, and Fox is there. He does have a fissure if they need to block someone out. Shadow Fiend is able to get a regeneration rune though, so bounty rune is now for Nendo, and oh, there's gonna be a hookshot on top of Indiana. He is stuck here. There's gonna be the Asian Seal as well. And he just eased a lot of harassment here from a battery assault. He's gonna die. Oh, long zip in. They're gonna go after Bende. Nendo, he's gonna go in strong, but he doesn't have enough HP and he needs to go out. There's gonna be the races to kill him off. It's a one for one trade here. Who is gonna be the victor out of it in the fight recap? It's gonna be, well, it's quite even, just a little bit more XP for Execration, while the gold goes away of R2D. I haven't read the Asian masculinity thing on Reddit. You could probably just tweet it to me at madnesscasting. I'll just put the link up here. I believe links are at the moment disabled through Moobot, so. Just send me a tweet, I'll put it in. So let's just get back into the game. At 11 minutes, it's quite down a little bit. Just 8 kills at the moment. And as we look at the net worth, Bende is the top farm with 5.3k here. Is he going to be the mecha carrier? No, he's not. He's going to build up Boots of Speed into Boots of Travel straight away. That's kind of fast here. That's not something I was expecting for him to go first here. Means that in Burden is most likely gonna go for a mecha, but he's just gonna get blown up here. This is this simple combination here. They just hookshot in and throw in a Mystic Flare. Primo will die for this. But still, it's kinda okay straight, I wanna say. Though the big victory is gonna be for R2D because they're behind. Okay. Kev is able to pick up his level 6 from this though. That's actually pretty big. He has a bunch of harassment here. He's already level 7 now. He's not putting in any points. Kind of bad. Estimoy. Yeah, what they're gonna do right now. Indiana, he is number 5 on the net worth chart right now. Nearing the 4k mark, or actually just over the 4k mark now. He's gonna go for a 4 step first. As he's gonna go in aggressive here with Nendo, and he has to get out. As he will. Bende, he's still pretty alive. I don't know what they're looking for right now. The tier 1 tower is going to be denied fairly soon. It's down to 90 HP, so I'm not expecting it to be alive for any longer. And this is something I didn't expect. Primo picked up a Midas here on the clockwork, so they kind of want to secure fast levels on him as well as farm, and just make sure that once it gets to late game that they have something to say. First is the Windranger, and he what, Nendo, he goes in aggressive here on Steamboy, but he has no more mana now. They're rotating in with three people, and he can go into the high ground here, but he doesn't have any kind of TPs. And there's gonna be the Cold Embrace on top of him, slowing it down quite heavily. Gonna get another hit on top of him. Yes, he will. There's gonna be the race to kill him off. Well, they're also able to pick up the kill on the Viper here on top with again a Mystic Flare Cox combination here. And this tower hasn't been denied. That was kind of a mistake. Now, Execration is just able to pick it up quite easily. Giving them some more gold. Let's just take a quick look at the charts here. Execration in the lead pretty heavily at the moment. At the 40 minute mark, they're about 4.7k ahead in gold. Experience is quite even. It's going to be about 1500 mark. Nothing too oppressive in that sense. As now they're just resorting back to farming here. First tower down of the game for... Oh, Nendo, he goes in aggressive, but Simo, he just goes into a Cold Embrace here. Still no Electric Vortex for Nendo here. Yeah, he has to run away. Bende just throwing down the right clicks on top of him, bringing him down to about half HP already. Oh, there's gonna be the hookshot though. Oh, yeah, they find him. Man, this Imburdened Viper is having a shitty game so far. Man, they tried to load up the Requiem here, but it's not gonna be enough. There's gonna be the Omnislash. Kills of the Winter River and kills of the Shadowfiend as well. Now Kev is gonna be the next one on the list. Or do they have enough to kill him off? Yes, they do. But there's gonna be the Deny with the Miscore there. And now the tier 1 is gonna be destined to follow. They do have a fortification, but they don't use it. Excavation taking the big fights here, taking some big wins as well. 2100 gold swing, not taking into account the tower as well, so that's gonna be another 1k at least. So about 3.4k gold swing and 2.1 experience swing for Execration. Just furthering their lead in this early game. And yeah, this Viper at the moment is just a big burden. He just has 2.5k and is not a hero that can farm his way back into the game. He's just gonna be easy feat here for the Execration lineup. They can just keep on going after him. I talked about, you know, the possibility of getting mechas on two heroes here, but Shadowfiend opting to go for BOTs, which I think is kind of a waste. Like, it does accelerate his farm speed, you know, you don't have to buy any more TPs, like, there are advantages of it. But it leaves him so damn squishy, it doesn't help his team. And Execration can just keep on pushing right now, like, there's no real reason for them to stop. As we're gonna see a Blink Dagger right now on Fox, he is able to purchase it already at 60 minutes in. It's a really good timing here for the Earthshaker, and he even just does a little bit of a celebrate Blink here in his own base. As the Storm is starting to build up for his Bloodstone right now, with the way he's snowballing, it's okay to get it. There's no real reason to not opt for it here, and yeah, I'm just really wondering what they're gonna do against this. RTD, they need to get a big team fight here, but they're fairly far behind. Is he gonna go in the end? There's gonna be the zip, there's gonna be the pullback. He tries to run away, but it's not gonna be enough. He gets off his shackle though on Fox, but Nando is able to get him just in time here. No, he's not. There's gonna be the Cold Embrace and the Mistcrow as well. Now Nando gets some Winter's Curse on top of him. They're gonna try and turn this one around as Bandai comes in as well. But Nando, he's gonna try and take someone with him. There's gonna be the shackle shot though, and he's not able to do so. As they're now gonna go after Fox. Viper Strike was also used on the Storm Spear. That's kind of a mistake. He should have probably used it on the on Fox here and just try to get a kill there. Now Fox is just able to live through it, but at least they get another kill out of this, and there's no kill for Execration. Well, they're just farming all over the map. Did they take a tower from this? I think Juggernaut just took the bot tower from this as well. As we're gonna go back to farming here, there's gonna be the Mask of Madness Yasha build here on Abeng. Oh, hookshot in. It's on top of Steamboy, but he's just gonna get four steps out. This Primo is now stuck here. He needs to get out. Do they have anything to stop it? No, they don't. And he's able to get out. Lumic comes in as well, and he just starts his retreat right away. Corrosive Sin is slowing him down. There's gonna be poison. There's gonna be the Shack Shot. He is last 2-3. He's gonna be sure to take a fall here as they're gonna go. Gonna go give a kill to R2D after this little bit of an aggressive movement from Execration, trying to push their luck a little bit. But they're at least, you know, always farming all over the map, pushing in all the lanes, and there's no real way for R2D to get any real objective out of it. But it's actually really, really cool courier. Man, this looks awesome. Well, let's leave it at that now. What's his name? Haunted Unusual Great Helm of the Long Name People. Okay, that's probably renamed. Ooh, Bandai is found. Double Fissure on the Slash. Are they able to kill off anybody here? Yes, they are. Viper is going to take a fall from here first. Well, Fox is going to just get out as well as the Juggernaut. Whoa, he is not actually able to do it. They just blow him up. Killing spree for Bandai here. They get a kill on in Burden, but is it really worth it right now? Oh, Primo, he's found out as well as he gets blown up here with Razes. Misko is going to be there to secure the kill for Kev. And Lumagis stacking a little bit up here, and they might just be able to get the first tier 1 of the game here as Execration is starting to get a little bit sloppy. Lumagis here, but he's walking forward fairly aggressively, and yeah, just one hit of the Shadow Fiend brings him down another 200 HP, so I think he's kind of thinking about it twice now. Now the 4-step here on Indiana's is pretty good versus the cogs of a clockwork. You know, you can just 4-step out yourself or your teammates. As Sanjay Yasha is now complete on Abeng, he builds up some stats here. Gonna get a little bit more tanky, might be looking at a Skadi next, as that's the usual build-up in this build. Now, there's gonna be some Glimmer Cape gaming soon, at least if Sitomboy is able to get some more farm. He is up His Cloak now is gonna start looking at his Shadow Amulet. Lumic, he's gonna go for the Talisman build here. Just get some more intelligence, you know. Just get a strong Arcane build as well. So a little bit more XP and mana pool. How's Nando doing? He's gonna get his Bloodstone delivered now. Being the third on the net worth list. Bendae is really just keeping RTD in the game here. At least in net worth. He's 9.8k, nearing the 10k mark. But his build is starting to pay off a little bit more now. But he needs to get something, like probably BKB next. Yeah, he can still get up, get blown up quite easily here with the Mystic Fair combination in with Cox and Ancient Seal. Pretty much anybody in the team of R2D can get blown up with it. They do have the force staff, so they kind of have one good point there. Nando, man, they're gonna look for Roshan here. Do they have a medallion or something? No, they don't. So they will need, they do need the Juggernaut here, but no wield, minus armor here. They are able to clear him down pretty fast here. As they're actually gonna get scouted out right now with the power shot. They're rotating in everybody from R2D right now. In the, yo, there's gonna be good Cox here. Oh no. Steamboy boy, he goes in aggressive and he's just gonna get caught out here. He gets up the Winter's Curse on Nando as his steam walks in here. Oh, and bang, he's gonna get hit by this Requiem of Souls. There's gonna be the Mystic Flare on 2 in Burden. It's gonna get cocked out. Kev is gonna pop his Burrow Time as they're gonna start cleaning up R2D here. Bendae falls down as well. Omni Slash has been used and he has died afterwards. It's a 2-for-2 trade right now. R2D, they actually buy back on the Shadow Fiend here. Nando has to start walking away. He needs to zip out as he will. In Burden is still pursuing him. Nando needs to zip further. Yeah, there we go. He TP's out. He should be able to survive from this. As it's a 2-for-2 trade with a buyback. It's still in favor of R2D. They get a little bit of a lead here. And buybacks, well, I don't think we're going to be looking at a high ground push anytime soon. So just getting his Aegis now for Bendae is going to be fine. This is going to be a Shackle shot on Fox as he gets killed off. And now Execration. They're kind of feeding away their lives here as well. So, oh, Primo is late. He's gonna die. He's not able to steal Roshan or snatch the Aegis. Execration kind of dropping the ball here. How's this looking in the charge right now? Is gonna go back to at least a 5k mark in experience. Is gonna be nearing into the zero experience. Oh man, this Aquilibrium is gonna be reached soon. The one good thing they have is Nando still is building up his Bloodstone charges right now. Yeah, I mean, what's this gonna go for? This is gonna be a tough choice here as Metastel is now completed on the Shadow Fiend, able to just get out of the Ancient Seal here. This is kind of a double-edged sword here versus Fox with the slam dunk, you know. Extra illusions means more potential damage versus for everybody, so it's gonna be a little bit dangerous here. The mechanism, okay, so they gave Kev the mechanism here. He's gonna be the Mecha Carriers in Burden is looking at. What is this? What is this build? Is this gonna be. No, it's not an armlet. What is this? This is odd. I don't know what he's going for. This is all over the place. I think he's gonna go back for a. For Blade Mill, as it looks like. But it's kind of all over the place. I don't get this Blade of Alacrity. Or Blade of Attack. That's kind of weird. Hmm. Well, Nando, he's gonna start building up for an Orchid now. Indiana, he's gonna start building into an Aghanim's. Kev, he got his Mecha now. Maybe start looking at a Greaves here, so you can get the reduced cooldown on the heal. Shadow Fiend, 1.5k gold up. I really wanna look at the BKB now. He kind of needs it. Teamfights have been going well so far, but need something extra, as Primo is starting to build up for his Aghanim's now as well. He's just kind of still down. R2D, they are still a little bit behind, not that big at 24 minutes though. And, oh, maybe they are able to find Primo, but Primo knows something is up. Oh, Shackle shot, but he just goes in Fizz. Ice in the Secret Store. There's gonna be a Sentry pop down, but they're not gonna be able to find him. And they're just pushing out all the lane here. There's some good split pushing coming from Execration. Oops. Pushing out all the lanes and just not giving RTD any real chance to use their Aegis to push down a lane. That said, they're not really trying to do it now anyway either. Nando, he's still farming here. In burden, he's really a burden in this match. This Viper just hasn't paid off at all. He's gonna be pretty much a non-factor here. Execration is kind of okay with the situation it is now. They do have a Midas here on Primo, so at least their offlaner is gonna be effective. Oh, Steamboy boy! He gets killed here. Vortex into Mystic Flare as TP out from Nando here. They have nothing to stop him. So he's just gonna go back to base as they get a pickoff here as well. Well, right now they're gonna go here on both. Primo, he's gonna get, well, focus fire, but he's gonna survive through this. Now Fox, he needs to get out. This corrosive skin, making sure that he can TP out or blink out, but he's still able to do it. They're not gonna pursue this. They're gonna leave him as there's gonna be another pickoff here for Execration. Or at least an aggressive movement might be the better way. I don't think they're gonna pick off there though. And yeah, this is gonna be the Skadi and Abing here. Picks up his first ultimate orb. Yeah, sorry guys, if you wanna get a your message here or a link, I'm gonna assume that's what you're gonna try and go for. Just send me a tweet at madnesscasting or just send me a message here on Twitch. I will just look at the link and maybe put it in, given that the link is something normal and they like it. Still, what's he going for? Yeah, this should be a blade mill. 1150 gold. He's trying to get it. It's now in the end. He got his Aghanims now. Might be looking at a crit stick next. Possibly a BKB. As Seaton boy, what's he going for? He's still gonna go for his Glimmer Cape. As the BKB is in the near future now for Bende. About 800 gold is short of it. Nando, he's really close to his Orchid here. Just need a couple more hundred gold. As they push in the tier 2 here on top, down to below health already. Kev, he's just building up some gold here. Oh, Indiana, he is caught out. Is he gonna die? Yes, he will. Clockwork picking up the dominating streak from him. They TP in people, but Bende that is, but it's a little bit too late. Execration is just really showing a lot of control in regard of just split pushing, as Fox is fairly aggressive here into the woods. I don't think he will be found out, but still looking for initiation here on top of Bende, but Bende is already moving back. Primus Haste is gonna end now, so a little bit less aggression there as some mid tier 2 skirmish here. Oh, Lumic, he's gonna get slowed quite heavily. Oh man, these slows are real, but he's just gonna survive through this. Walks away. And man, this Aegis from R2D just hasn't been used at all. They have still been confined all the way back into their own side of the map. As Execration is nearing the 10k mark here, it's just showing great map control. Making sure that they can push. There was a bit of a dip there. They lost a lot of kills. They gave actually a lot of kills, I want to say. But that's kind of a happy-go-lucky hookshot there. But yeah, it just wasn't anything there. They lost Roshan, but still, they just look at it. They're pushing out bot mid. And RTD, they're just running around the map at all times, but they're not able to do anything here. They're not farming well. Their own jungle is invaded as hell. They have absolutely no control here apart from one ward on here on the mid lane, which is just not gonna be enough versus all this vision from the side of Execration. Map control is just completely inside of Execration here. It's RTD, they need to go and do something here. They know that the Clockwork is looking for Indiana here. They have the two defensive supports here behind him. Primo, I don't think he should go for this. This might be a little bit of a mistake, but they're also kind of scared on the side of R2D. They're afraid, you know, this might be backup. Damn, they're just so stuck in the base right now. They're just not able to go anywhere. Primo, he's gonna start building up for a four step for himself here with this step of wizardy. Yeah, RTD, they need to do something because they're just gonna get out farmed here. Yeah, just a couple of seconds ago, a couple of minutes, it was 10k and now it's already over 12k, nearing the 14k. It's just being this map control all the way for Execration. I can't just stress this enough. So I'm just not able to really do anything. Yeah, this okay. At least I have the BKB on Bende now. Their team fight should be a little bit stronger here, but they're still fairly far behind as a Rod of Athos is now purchased up on the Skywrath Mage, one of the heroes that does just so much with it. Same as the Silencer, just his intelligence just buffs up his skill so much, as well just having the slow, making sure that everybody is stuck in the Azian Shield Mystic Flare combination. Oh, they smoke up here on the side of RTD. Are they able to find something? Ebbing is here, Fox as well. And oh, they see everybody. There's gonna be the Shackle Shot. There's gonna be the Winter's Curse and Ebbing. And they're able to bring him down in time here. There's gonna be a reinforcement. Ebbing taking a lot of damage. He's just gonna turn around and Omni Slash on top of them. Is he? He's getting off quite a good Omni Slash. He has Primo comes in as well. He gets. Yeah, he's now stuck here, kind of alone. As the Clockwork at least gets a kill on the Winter Wyvern, but he will pay with his life. Lumic. He's trying to fight up versus Bende, but the Rod of Athos is able to keep him alive. There's gonna be the Yules. Bende, he just keeps on being stuck here as on the top. Nando gets a kill with his DD here and he's a back off. And oh, the kill of Bende here. The two supports kill him off. 3-4-1 trade at the moment for Execration, taking a big win as well as the top tier 3 here. Some harassment into the range barracks, but nothing that big. And just a big team fight again. Now, again. It took some time for Execration to get another big team fight here like this. It isn't the biggest change, but it's really just a bunch of control that they now get again. They get tier 3 top, tier 2 on bot. So now the access for Roshan is just going to be so much harder, as they also spot out the Asian stack here. This triple stack, Ebbing says thank you for it. And he's just going to start farming this one away, as this is going to be so tough for them to get back on. Oh, this is just a lot of gold. 1800, 18k gold on the Juggernaut here, man. He is almost 5k ahead on Bendang, and it's going to be tough for him. He's building up for his Eagle Song into a butterfly now, and this means Shadow Fiend has to start build up a butterfly and MKB, and he's just not close to that at all. This, and also in burden, this Viper, he's just being a burden right now. He's just not able to do anything, as we might see a Link Sphere here soon on Nando. Only 200 gold off of it. They're all getting together here for Roshan. I'm gonna imagine Nando is gonna get there soon, being the probably the best Aegis carry in the game, so he will start moving his way there as well. He might, he should be on time. We can just sip in if needed. What does Lomi? He's still there, the same. Primo, it's kind of the same as well. Do we finally have the Glimmer Cape though? Yeah, we do have a Glimmer Cape now, so we might see a gem come out as Roshan will take a fall. Now Nando picks it up. He has his Linkus, he has his Orchid, his Bloodstone, his Aegis. So he can just go in full on aggressive as they smoke up here on the side of R2D. But this smoke is just to get back in the base, as it seems like. They might have tried to do something aggressive with it, but it's too late. The Aegis is already gone. And now they're on the back lines. The smoke up behind Abeng here. And yeah. Nando, he will probably be the first person on the line here. Yeah, if they go forward here, they might just take a fall. This might just be the last hold for R2D here in this best of one in the Corsair Gaming Arena. Oh, and they go in. Bendang, he's getting focused fight down. Is he gonna survive through all of this? There's gonna be the Cold of Brace keeping him alive for now. Winter's Curse as well. Requiem of Souls doesn't kill off anybody for now, but he is still alive here right now. Bendang going strong. There's gonna be the Echo Slam hitting him. Oh, they're now starting to clean up on the side of RTD. This is gonna be GG. Three people down. They get just one kill. Fox is the only one dead at the moment. Kev is gonna take a fall as well. He denies himself with the muscle. It's only Indiana left.
Nando, he still got his Aegis, so they can just keep on going. Hookshot on Indiana, 5 men down, and they have just one buyback on Kev. Ladies and gentlemen, this is gonna be the GG. Because they're not able to hold their base. They're gonna lose at least 2 sets of Rex, and even after that, they still have the Aegis, so they can keep on fighting strong. They just need to wait. And they can even just go back, because it's just... There's just no way for R2D to really win from this. 2 lanes down, 25k on both XP as well as gold here. As you can see, it's gonna be so tough here. As Nando, he just says, screw this shit. He's gonna go on Steam Mobile and just zips out as well. He says, hey, I got an Aegis. I don't really care that much. Go after me. I don't care. It doesn't matter. Touting them into death. Well, his team is just taking the bot lane. They're gonna be mega creeps in a matter of seconds here, as Kev, they just GG out right now. This game is won now by Execration. This was a best of one, of course. So let's take a quick look at who they are gonna be facing. They're gonna be facing Signature Trust, who were the winners in their own game there between Team Assail. So GG to Execration being the favorites in this match. They are also just showing why they are winning the game from R2D. They had a little bit of a sloppy mid game, at least sloppy 5 minutes, I want to say, where they just gave away some kills that they didn't have to, but they showed extreme control of the map, pushing out all the lanes at all time. Even though they lost, they gave an Aegis pretty much to R2D. They weren't able to really, R2D wasn't really able to capitalize on it. All the lanes were pushed out at all times, split pushing extremely well with their Jugger, with their Storm, as well as with Primo on the Clockwork, just sending out the Rocket Flares, pushing out the lanes, and they just, you know, they had that clarity moment, like, damn, we gave away too much, let's just take it all back, and they just dominated after that. And R2D, they just didn't have a response for this, and that means Execration wins in the Crosshair Gaming Arena number 5 here. They're gonna go into round 2. That's gonna be the quarterfinal for the Signature Trust. I was Sander casting here on the Swiss DCEN channel. You can follow me at MadnessCasting on Twitter. Also follow our Facebook Swiss DC and our Twitter at Swiss_DC. Follow our Twitch here as well, as we send out GDL, our own tournaments, as well as anything we can pretty much get our hands up that is fun. So guys, I hope to see you soon again. This was Sander signing out.